Hello, welcome to the world of art. Yes, engineering is an art. Here we build things that makes our life easier. Hoover Dam, Panama Canal, Burj Khalifa are some of the engineering wonders of the world. Spacecraft that sends man to the moon or a skyscraper built to withstand an earthquake all have one thing in common. They are made to solve a problem and to make life easier for humankind. From a philosophical perspective, engineering is simply applied science. Science is hence obviously important, as without knowing science, you can't apply it. Science teaches us about the laws of natural world, and the mathematics helps us to establish relationship among different quantities. Science and mathematics are integral part of engineering. So, we must build a very understanding of science and mathematics, because these are the foundations upon which our study will be based. Let us take an example of an architect or even a civil engineer who works by the rules of maths and physics virtually every day. It's obviously difficult. Imagine someone without basics of arch, columns, roofs, lintels or other structures. In engineering, students learn all extensive use of Laplace and Fourier transform equations, which is related to linear algebra in circuit theory and signal processing. Mathematics brings about most invaluable real-world solutions in our problems. How do we make a 300-ton aircraft fly through the sky? How do we build a bridge that can cross a 1-kilometer river? How do we stop skyscrapers from collapsing during an earthquake? Applied mathematics is often used to solve complex practical problems. In truth, all the greatest engineering accomplishments and inventions of 20th century were feats of mathematics. I remember a quote: scientists build to learn, engineers learn to build. Engineering is the use of maths and science to solve problems. There are physical principles embodied in the science of physics and chemistry that lead to engineering application. Physics can be broken down into the study of electricity, optics, electromagnetism, and mechanics. A deep understanding of each one of those areas is required to become a successful engineer in each discipline. Various types of engineers employ different areas of science. For example, a chemical engineer relies very heavily on chemistry and fluid mechanics to make raw materials into usable products. Likewise, a mechanical engineer may vary in energy conversion and use thermodynamics, fluid mechanics, and heat transfer to design a power plant. Civil engineers use statics, dynamics, geomechanics, and fluid mechanics to plan and maintain the environment we live in. Engineers apply the scientific method in deriving their solutions. In most branches of engineering, we need good maths and science skills so we can develop innovating, enduring solutions and transform the latest scientific discoveries into enabling new technologies. Thank you.